your ass up, cause it's time to go beast mode.
You know me, Spider-Man. I am here with...
We were the Paladins of Cosplay, but we each have our own unique identities as well. I go by Ali Z Cosplay.
I'm Al, Rain River Images.
I'm Fabian, I go by It's Fabian.
And I'm Law, I go by Outlaw2LK on all my socials.
What inspired you guys to make this a thing, to make this happen? Because you had it in 2020, and that was the first one.
We were going to have a Paladins of Cosplay shoot with just the Paladins of Cosplay, and then maybe some of our close friends. So we all thought of a couple people we wanted to invite, and then when Fabian was talking about who he invited this person, this person, this person, this person, and I'm thinking about
this
person's aunt, this person's grandmother.
So I gave them a list. They just kept going, but they didn't tell me.
And the names kept going, and I said, wait a second, Fabian, how many people did you invite? I don't know, like 50?
So understand, this was supposed to be a private event, a private photo shoot, that turned into a whole media event, now with like tons of people. We had to literally shoot this in a stairwell because of all the madness out there. We're in a stairwell. I mean, this does look like a really good album cover. Now that it's a thing, here's the question. How do you pick, I know this is an edgy question, how do you pick who gets invited? Because I know this is still technically a private event. What is the criteria to like get in on this? Do you have to be like somebody's cousin, you know, dating somebody in the squad, like some, you know, a side piece? I'm a side piece, like.
That's a different
interview. That's a different interview. That's a different interview. Like, don't worry about it. Oh, that's precious. So, how do you get involved in this? How can you be notified? Is there a way that people could be interested that may want to join? Are you thinking, an additional question, are you thinking about expanding or keeping it, like containable? Why don't y'all explain exactly what Lightbenders is?
Lightbenders is, how I see it, is a networking event that gets together photographers and cosplayers. When you go to these comic cons, they have all these vendors and all that. But then there's this whole different world that, which I discovered at comic con, to be like photographers and cosplayers, they network among each other. So we just wanted to create an environment, a more intimate environment without all the hoopla and everything like that, where people can just come and enjoy, you know, and network and evolve within their craft, because there are a lot of talented cosplayers, you know, unnoticed cosplayers, you know, underrated cosplayers. And cosplaying is not about just, you know, wearing a costume. It's a craft. It's serious craft, for the lack of a better word.
You whether, know? Whether it's physically building a costume or or the actual art and craft of acting.
Right. Mm-hmm. And me as a photographer, it's like if somebody puts that so much passion into that craft, then that has to be photographed well. Well, it has to be photographed the way it was meant to be, you know. It'd be like, you always use this quote, don't shoot what it is, shoot what it feels like. So it gives it an extra dimension of that character that they built, you know.
Yeah, so I was gonna say, like, this is an event where it's like a con without being a con, that focuses on photography and videography, as well as cosplay.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's not really like vendors or anything like right. that. It is like a photo shoot convention.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, to like, because there's people that come out and get really amazing like shots for their, you know, social media or their portfolios or what have you to show off their cosplay. And it's great for if they get like a guest spot somewhere, they can use these series of awesome photos that'll help attract even more fans.
Mm.
And I like that there's a focus on the photographers as well, because a lot of times in the cosplay scene, the cosplayer is recognized, but the photographer isn't.
Right.
People behind the camera, yep.
Yeah, and it's important to know that without the people behind the camera, your cosplay is not going to get the same recognition. It's those dope photos that people see online that go like, wow, that looks awesome. That looks just like the movie, or that looks like a show, or whatever. Like, that's super creative. Yeah, and there's a ton of talent that was here.
We have different photographers that shoot different styles,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they experiment. And that's another thing for as photographer, for my, they get a chance to experiment with different cosplays and different ideas and different lighting.
And it's cool because like you can like sign up when you come here to the event. You sign up with, you know, different photographers, and then you, you know, pick your times and all that stuff. And you go in, you get your shots, and then like boom, bam, like you know, you obviously give them an like, email or something like that where your shots yeah. can be sent, and then boom, you have this amazing portfolio from all these different, you know, photographers that all have different techniques and different mm-hmm. styles and different ways to interpret the visage
mm-hmm.
that is you, the cosplayer. Thanks for like making this happen and bringing these people out. Thank you for having me out. You know, I love you guys. You guys are awesome.
We want to be exclusive, but we are also very inclusive. We have an invite list. Even though it's grown
because of some of us.
It's growing because of all of the positivity that a lot of cosplayers are bringing. A lot of cosplayers that don't bring drama to the scene, that bring their creativity full on. And that's what we try to focus on. And if as long as they are, you know, positive in the community, positive overall, and provide the shed the proper light on cosplay, they end up on the invite list for the most part.
Right. What's unique about this event is there kind of needs to be a mutual trust between the photographer and the cosplayer, because a lot of the times people shy away from each other at public conventions, so to speak, because it's almost like stranger danger. You don't really know, you know, who you're meeting at the time. You just see this person with a camera, or you see a cosplayer with a cool costume. And for an event like this to happen and be successful, it kind of does need to have a little bit of a vetting process, because we're saying, hey, these are our photographers we know and trust.
Mm-hmm.
They are here to create art. Here are cosplayers who we know who, you know, have worked hard on their costumes, or they're like super passionate about being in character and like creating content. So like that's kind of why we do have the vetting process, although I wouldn't say it's like loss of exclusive. It's, we want to include
as many
people as we can
with the capacity that the venue will allow us to.
Right.
Yeah.
Snack.